This tutorial for Directory Opus looks at ways to automate the creation of complex directory structures. Even if that isn't something that you need to do now, the techniques we'll look at can be applied more generally and should give you ideas about using Opus to help solve other problems. We'll start with some examples of what can be done with the functionality built into Opus. Then, we'll look at how simple buttons and hotkeys can be used to create a short list of directories below the current folder. Finally, we'll look at how an external script can be integrated into Opus to do even more. Let's pretend that we're running a small talent agency for actors seeking work in film, stage, and television. To keep track of everyone, we've created a directory for each actor. Within each actor's folder, we have a PDF about the actor, which we can send out to people doing casting. We also have a folder of publicity photos, another folder where we keep track of auditions, and a group of folders where we keep track of the actor's work in commercials, film, stage, and television. So each of our actors has the same set of folders. Okay. Let's say three new actors sign up to our talent agency. We've been sent a zip file for each actor, and that contains a PDF, some photos, and possibly details of any existing bookings. Let's add our first new actor by hand. I'll be using the New Folder button or Ctrl+N hotkey, but the right-click menu also works, just like in Explorer. You can create multiple folders this way by typing a list of names separated by commas. And I can move these files over now. It's also possible to create subfolders using a backslash between the two parts. So, this is all fine for a one-off job, but it's going to be quite tedious and error-prone if you need to do it often. To speed things up, I've made a button which asks for an actor's name, and then creates all the folders for that actor. You can download a copy of this zip via the link in the description below the video. I'll extract the zip, and then in Customize mode, drag the button into the New Folder menu, since it's related to the other things there. And I'll quickly show you the code behind this button. The first line prompts for the actor's name, and stores it in a variable. Each of the other lines creates one of the folders for that actor. I've also given the button a hotkey so that I can trigger it without opening the menu. So let's give this button a try. I'll paste in the next actor's name. And as you can see, it's created all the required folders for that actor. Let's do the last of our three new actors, and I'll use the hotkey this time. And there we go. So I didn't have to think about which directories to create, it was all done for me, and I can get on with moving the files into place. Now that's made it really easy to set up a handful of actors, but let's say we've just merged with another talent agency, and now we have a huge list of people to add to our system. Even with our button, this will be a pain. We really want to be able to give Opus this list of names and have it create all the appropriate directories for us. And that's exactly what our second button does. As well as the button itself, which we'll look at in a minute, we also have two text files and a VB script. Those extra files need to be put somewhere, and I'm going to put them in the Opus configuration directory. You can go there by typing /dopusdata. Dopus data is an alias. Note that the directory I ended up in has my name in it. The path will be different for everyone, but we can all use the same alias to take us to the right place. From here, create a scripts folder. Although it doesn't exist by default, a folder called scripts is treated specially. Any files you put inside of it will be included when you do a config backup or USB export using Settings, Backup and Restore. By copying the files here, they will travel with the rest of your configuration, and buttons which depend on these files will work without you having to remember to copy extra things around. Note that this will work only for files directly below the scripts folder, and if you create any subdirectories, they will not be backed up. So let's look at the files we've just moved over. You've already seen the actors text file. The actor subdirs file contains a list of folders to create for each actor, similar to our first button. And I'll show you the VB script quickly, but I'm not going to talk about it too much, as this isn't supposed to be a VB script tutorial. If you're familiar with VB script, then this should be quite simple, but don't worry if you're not. And you don't have to use VB script, of course, other scripting languages and tools will work just as well. Now for the button. The button runs the script and passes it some command line arguments. It's all on one line, but let me split it up so I can talk about it more clearly. The alias Opus data code is used a few times to refer to the Opus configuration directory. Remember a moment ago when we typed in /opusdata to go there? This is inserting exactly the same path into the command and means the button will work without having to edit it for your username. The current folder is also passed to the script so that it knows where to create the directories. You could hardcode the folder here instead, so that you could click the button from anywhere and always have the folders created in a fixed place, and that's up to you. The button will also prompt you for the paths to the two text files containing the actor and subdirectory names, which we saw earlier. Whichever files you select will be passed on the command line to the script. By prompting you for those files, you're given the opportunity to choose different lists each time you run the button. It also helps remind you where the list files are, since the prompts will open with them selected by default. If you wanted the same files to be used every time you click the button, then you could remove the prompts and just specify the paths. So let's run the button and create all those new actors. The button asks for the two text files, and I'm telling it to use the defaults. And as you can see, that was all done really quickly with very little effort or thought required. We just created about 300 folders at the click of a button. This button can also help update existing folders if we later decide that we need new subfolders for each actor. For example, let's say our actors are now being booked to do computer game voiceovers. So we'll add a new folder to that list. And at the moment our actors list only includes the new actors, we need to include everyone. So let's put all the actor names into the clipboard and paste that over the old list. By the way, blank lines are okay in this list and will be ignored. So let's run that. And as you can see, each actor now has a new games folder. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope it's given you some ideas on how you can use Opus to get things done. Thank you for watching, and also thanks to everyone who let me use their photos. Bye for now!